What do you think? Is table tennis more mental or physical? Is table tennis something that you need to consciously think about, or is it something that just flows out? There's many misperceptions, and today I'd like to make a few clarifications. There's a lot of books out there. One book's called With Winning in Mind. This book talks about many different things, but particularly the conscious mind and the subconscious mind. This chapter really kind of stuck out to me, and many people read content like this. They read it, but they're not necessarily able to take the content and apply it to their table tennis game. They read it, they agree, and they say, yeah, these things are good, but how do you take this content and apply it to your game? Let me just read a couple short sentences, and then I'm going to give you application. Okay, this section is called the conscious mind. The conscious mind contains your thoughts and mental pictures. The conscious mind controls all the senses, seeing, hearing, smelling, tasting, and touching. It is what you picture or think about. Every time we think about something, we do it consciously. The conscious mind processes our environment. Okay, that's the conscious mind. The subconscious mind now. The subconscious mind is the source of your skills and power to perform. All great performances are accomplished subconsciously without much conscious thought. We develop skills through repetition of conscious thought until the subconscious mind automatically performs them. The conscience trains the subconscious, okay? So this is the reason that getting professional coaching from the very first day of your playing career is critically important. Why? Because you're going to play your absolute best when you're able to use more of the subconscious mind and let it happen. Table tennis is such a fast sport that we can't consciously make all the necessary decisions. We need to really be able to tap into the subconscious mind. You've heard a lot of coaches or a lot of players say, you got to practice more, you got to practice more. What are they talking about? Are they really trying to rope you into just living in your basement 8 hours a day or living at this training center 6 hours a day and you really have to practice that much? Well, it does require a lot of practice, but what they're actually saying is that you need to be able to tap into the subconscious so it becomes automatic. Without repetition, it's not going to become automatic. The problem is, if you don't get coaching and you just repeat your bad habits over and over again, then those bad habits become part of the subconscious and you just automatically play those bad habits. So what do you need to do? First of all, you need to set personal goals. Second thing, you're going to have a coach that can help you to train the conscious mind, to train your body on how to do the right things. Third thing is, you got to stick with the game plan. And fourth thing is, you have to have a long-term perspective, realizing that the muscle memory for continually program your body with the conscious mind, it does take time for it to become subconscious. Okay, Samson, so I took your advice. I set my goals, I got my coach, I programmed many hours, I got my game all together. I've got the strokes, the footwork, the balance, positioning, timing, spin. I have everything right, and now I'm starting to do well in tournaments. Should I be playing tournaments more in the conscious mind where I'm actually thinking about my game, thinking about what I should be doing? Or should I be using more of the subconscious mind where I'm just in the flow of things and I'm just letting it happen? Well, the answer is actually both, because we need to be able to have an understanding of generally what we're doing, especially as it relates to the specific tactics used against the opponent. The serves we're choosing to use, the returns we're choosing to use, the ball placement. We are making conscious decisions. But at the same time, most of our game should be in the automatic stage. It should be in the subconscious where we're just allowing ourselves to play. We don't actually have to think about, now how much weight do I put on that back leg when I'm transferring my weight from the right foot to the left foot? Exactly what racket angle should I use? Exactly how much pressure should I put with my thumb? How much pressure should I put with this finger? We're not thinking about those details of that. We're thinking more about the tactics. Now, from match to match, it's going to change a little bit. Let's say, for example, you win the first game 11-2, and you go over to your coach. He probably is not going to tell you too much. He's just going to pat you on the back and say, hey, there's a few things you did great this game. Keep doing those. Okay, so basically the coach is not trying to tap into the conscious mind. He's not trying to get you to overthink. He's just trying to allow you to just let it go and continue like you've done. Now, let's just say you lose the first game. Maybe 11-6, all right? And now all of a sudden we're down 5-0 in the next game. He calls timeout and you go over and he starts tapping into the conscious mind because you need to be able to override it. Maybe, let's say, for example, your backhand push, you keep pushing into the net, into the net, into the net, into the net. If he just told you, Billy, just let it flow, you're going to probably just keep doing the same mistake, right? So what does he have to do? He has to tap into your conscious mind by being able to explain to you, okay, with what you're doing right now, with the amount of pressure that you're putting on the ball, with the feel, with the timing, with your approach, with your follow through, what's happening right now is not working. This is what you need to do. So basically what ends up happening is from match to match, it's going to kind of ebb and flow as far as, are you using more of the conscious mind or the subconscious mind? In conclusion, how do you have your best performance? Well, if it's an important tournament and you want to have your best performance, that's great. But first thing you have to realize is that you have to have the game for it, okay? If you are at this level and you're expecting to go out there and beat all these players, you probably haven't put in the time, you probably haven't put in the years, you probably don't have that foundational game it's gonna take to take down all these guys. So the first thing is you have to be realistic and you've gotta develop the game initially. This takes many years to develop. The next thing is, as you're getting ready for that peak tournament, you gotta play other tournaments as well, and you need to learn to play more with the subconscious mind, allowing yourself to just play, as opposed to being too analytical on every single detail of your game. See, when you're developing, it's mainly about you, your side of the net, your footwork, your balance, your strokes. But as you're getting ready to play that peak tournament, your ultimate goal in your table tennis life, you really need to be able to tap more into the subconscious mind. So you and your coaches kind of have to have a mutual understanding of what that entails. What does it entail? It entails talking less about the finger position on the racket. It involves less as far as changing strokes. It involves a lot less as far as developing new weapons that you're not used to using. And it just develops confidence in being able to think about the other side of the net. Confidence in being able to actually analyze the opponent and just focus on executing the shot as opposed to the mechanics for how the shot is done. So what stage are you at? Are you still at the developing stage? No problem. Continue to train the conscious mind. You're not going to have amazing results right now, but you've got to develop the game. If you don't use the conscious mind and develop the skills now, you'll never reach that peak level. Or are you at the stage that you already have that really strong game? You've already developed amazing strokes, amazing footwork, and just for some reason, you just can't put it all together in a tournament. Well, you need to start trusting yourself and trusting your game more and being less analytical on your own self and more analytical on your opponent. I'd love to have you at the Samson Dabena Table Tennis Academy. If you have any questions, feel free to send me a message. I'd love to talk to you.